Hi everyone, so happy you took the time again to come over and watch a new video from Diana Me. For everyone who is new here and sees me for the first time, my name is Yanni and I'm doing this channel together with my daughter-in-law Diane. And of course today I take you along in such an easy DIY. I hope you enjoy a little bit of farmhouse and a little bit of the spring season. I have to say it right, the little bit of the spring season. I hope you will enjoy. If you like a little bit of chaos and you like this content, I hope you will consider subscribing to Diane and my channel. We would love to have you here. We already have so many beautiful friends and we are so thankful for all their friendships they're giving us every time and time again. So thank you all for that. And like I always say, enough talking, let's jump into our DIY. So these are the only couple of things you need for your wall art piece. And of course everyone knows this kind of wall art. It is just, you can make it from paper and you can make it from fabric, but what I'm going to do is make it from cardboard because it's a little bit more should I say that right? I hope I say that right. So you just need 2 pieces of cardboard, 8 pieces of your painter's tear sticks, and some wax to make a little bit of the rustic color for your tear sticks. Of course you can also paint them in the white color if you like, more white or black or any color you like. You just can do whatever you want. I'm going to paint this cardboard, and most of the time the wall art is also made from fabric because you can roll it up. And but I will make it from some cardboard because it's a little bit more gives a little bit more body to your art, and it doesn't fall inside the falls down. So I'm going to use this. So let's paint this one first. So I just told you that we're going to paint my cardboard, and of course we will. But what I totally forgot is when you have your 2 piece, because I'm going to make 2 piece of wall art, I have to measure out my painter stick, but I want to have it a little bit more that my painter stick is a little bit going outside. This is what I mean. I will have to, that one piece, a little piece of my painter sticks is sticking out. So I have to measure out how much I'm going to, I think a little bit over here. So I will cut this one first, measure it out, and then I will cut it out, and then it is better to fit it to my wall art. Of course you can do any measurement you like. This is more what I like. So you see I draw the line, and now I will cut this off, and then you will see that he is totally fitting over here. I show you that in a moment. I see a little bit that my camera is a little bit dark. I hope you can still see, because I do the bright light, it is so bright to look at. So what I'm going to do is, you see here I just have a little piece over sticking over here and a little piece over here, and when we have painted this, then we are going to squeeze a little bit 2 painter sticks in between the cardboard in between my 2 painter sticks, and use this a little bit how it will look like. And of course this is a little bit strange because my hands are my hands are going up and down, but you still can't see it. So this is a little bit what I mean. And of course we also will do the underside of our cardboard, but now I'm going to paint this one first. So I will paint it in this color. That is the old white chalk paint. So I always do it in an old jar, because then my paint is not getting that old. I have to do a couple of layers. So I will do first this layer, and then I will do the rest. So I'm going to do this one, and then I show you how they are looking like when they are finished. So you see, while my cardboard is drying, I am going to do the painter sticks. I will do some wax on it. You can do whatever you want. You can do, of course, you can color it. Just do it in a white color. You can do it. I don't know. There are so many ways you can do your pieces in. I give only the front side a nice coat, because the back side I use, of course, to glue it on top of my cardboard. So I'm only doing the top of this one. So I will do all of them, all 8 of them, and then I show you how they are looking like on my board. So you see, I did all 8 of them, and you see how they are already turned into a little bit of the rustic, a little bit more of the old field. I don't know how you call it, but like I said, if you like it a little bit more, just paint it in your color you want. It's just your own privilege, what you want. I like a little bit of the rustic feeling of my piece. So we let it dry right now, and then we are going to work on our cardboard. So here you see the cardboard dried up. I did only 2 coats on them, because I will distress it a little bit, so that's why I think 2 layers is more than enough, and I will do a print on top of this. So what I'm going to do, I have an old you already see it's an old brush, and I use it always for my wax. I also use it a moment ago for my painter sticks. And you see here, I am just going at the sides of my board. I hope I do it in front of you, and just give it a little bit of an old look. So just do a little bit what you think it's right around the edge, and of course this one will be under my, but just do it a little bit higher, because here you will have the little painter stick, and you will see a little bit what is coming out of it. So it's here, just make some little pieces, and just, it is no rhyme or reason how you must do it, just give it a try. I am no expert. I'm just doing something, and I'm just trying it. But it just gives a little bit of an old feeling, especially at the sides. And I like that the cardboard gives an old little bit of damaged side. So I really like that. So I will do this one also, and then we are going further to do our print on top of it. So here you see, both of them are distressed right now with a little wax, and of course you can use some paint for it also to distress a little bit. What we need right now is 2 prints for on top of my wall art, and of course you can use it in your kitchen, you can use it anywhere. My thing is, I'm going to try to do a week calendar, so you can use it every time again with some little notes on the days. So we're going to try if this will work out or not, so come along with me. So this is how they eventually turned out. You just saw me making them, and I think they turned out so nice. So we are going to try to get them on top of my wall art. Yeah, I just call it wall art. I don't know how you really call it. And we are going to make this on top of our cardboard. So you see, you still use only some cardboard and some paper and some old sticks from painting. So nothing expensive. Everything is cheap and yeah, on a budget. So I'm going to glue this on top of my board. So I measured it out, a little line I did over here and a little line over here. So I'm sure that my print will be a little bit in the middle. I don't use this time Mod Podge because I'm really a little bit afraid that he will be very wrinkly. So I'm going to try to do this one, but I don't know if this will work or not, and maybe I will do later on some Mod Podge over it. So, but I'm going to try to do this first, but maybe it's the wrong decision, I don't know, but we will see. And now I'm sure where I want to have my print. And just make a little turning movement just to warm up a little bit of your print, so he will stick a little bit better. And I think I will, later on I will do a layer of Mod Podge over it. I don't know if this will work or not, but you see already, he is already looking so nice and so easy. And it is only already great to just to have it inside. Even if you don't use it, it is already nice, and you just can do a little print of it on it just for decoration. You don't have to use it, of course. I will do this one, and then I show you how we do the wooden sticks on top and on the underside. So you see, this is already a little bit how they turned out. I find them already very rustic and old, and what I did try is do on top of it I did some Mod Podge. I am not sure because it's not totally dry yet, but I'm not sure if that is a success. So we will see in when everything is dried up if it will work or not. What we're going to do first right now is do our sticks on top of each other. So we are going to do some glue on my painter sticks, a little bit over here, and we are going to do some together with some glue gun. So we let this dry for a moment, and then we're going to squeeze it on top of our, but I think you already know a little bit what the meaning is. The meaning is on top of here and this one, and the cardboard will be in between of both of their painter sticks. So but I let this dry for a little moment, and then we are going to do some glue gun on it, and then we hope that it will stick together. So the glue is dried up for a little bit, so we're going to do right now do some glue gun on top of it also. But this is the glue from AliExpress, and I really don't recommend it. So if you need some glue, don't use it from them, because I am not really happy with it. And now we're going to do this, and now I hope it will go in between. First I'm going to do this part. Also squeeze the cardboard a little bit flat, so already your piece won't be too thick. So this is one, and what we're going to try right now, and just squeeze it in. Of course it doesn't glue immediately, of course it doesn't So now we're going to do the other piece, and we have to squeeze it on top of each other, and that we will hold a little while, and then I show you if it if it works or not. So what I did forgot to show you in the video, because my camera was not on and I thought he was on, I did the glue and I did the tops on each other. And what I did immediately is just go in with your twine and just give it a great turning on top of it, so you have some that they are squeezing the little painter sticks on top of each other, so you can't go anywhere. So this is just cut it out, just lay a knot in top of it, and then he can dry, but then he stays better this way, of course. And don't do it just the way I do it, to move him to the other one. So you see now he is squeezing the parts with each other. I'm sorry, I'm very chaotic right now, but I think you already know what I mean. Just turn them a couple of times around so you are sure that they are still fitting on top of each other, and just again lay a knot on top of them so he can dry and he will stick together. So you see, this is what I mean. Now you have them covered up inside of the ropes, and now he can dry when everything is in between. So we let it dry for a while, and then we are going to make some little hanging cord over here, and then we are almost done. So, but I think they already turned out so nice. So here you see how they turned out when they dried up. You just saw me making that. I did glue the print with normal glue on top of the cardboard, and I just did some Mod Podge on top of it. I'm sorry, I did some Mod Podge on top of it, but you just see I just everywhere I have some faded pieces, and that just gives, by it was just it was just luck, but it just gives more and more the old feeling of an old piece of paper you have on your wall art. So I'm very, very happy how it turned out. So maybe something for you, if you can just glue it and just do Mod Podge over it, and then you will see it gives a more of an old feeling to your print. So for me it was just luck, but you can make a vanity of it, so maybe you can use it twice sometime also. And I am very how these two are looking like. The only thing what we need to do right now is do a couple of times, just we need a handle because we want to hang it. So, and I don't like one thread, so I'm making a couple of them, and we are going to, you just see, I will make them on the back side of my art. I do this piece of twine, and what you also can do, if you like a little bit more of color, you can do some ribbon under it or on top of it. This is not what I'm going for today, but I will show you that how it can look like. So here I have two pieces of ribbon. You can use, of course, a Mackenzie Child print, and you can use a stripe print, but some people like it when they can see a little print under it. So you still can do, I just lay it on under it, and you just make some fishtails on it, and then I can show it to you. This may be better than that I'm going to explain it to you. So I am going to, I have to do it this way, and that, yep, don't do it, don't do it. You see, I'm very dangerous with scissors. Most of the time I cut myself, so I'm doing just this way. So this is a little bit, it's not the greatest fishtail, but you make one of your own. It's just for showing you how you can do it, so you can just do a little piece under your wall art. I when I see it right now, it is maybe something to consider. I really like how it is looked like. Just maybe it gives a little bit more of a farmhouse touch. So maybe I will do this this way, but we will see. But first I'm going to make my twine on top of my art. So I just take a little piece of glue and I'm just gluing the twine. I took 4 pieces because I want to have it a little bit thicker, so I'm just gluing this on top of it and remove the pieces of glue you don't, so they are falling off. At least I always have so many glue pieces, so just do it this way and just glue also the other side. I just take some glue. So I did my twine on, you already see it this way, and I really am liking how it looks under it. So I am just gluing some pieces of, at least where my glue gun is ready to go. look at this, I am really stuck in my own glue. So just glue 2 pieces of ribbon a little bit sideways on top of each other, so you get a little bit like this, and just do some glue on top of that ribbon, and then we are gluing it under. We have to do it of course in the middle and glue it under your wall art piece, and you just see, you just get a little bit more. I really love how it looks like, a little fishtail under it. I will do the other one and then I show you how everything is looking. So here are my 2 pieces of wall art turned out. I will go a little bit closer. So I just place them for now to show you on my blackboard, and it looks very nice. And I love the farmhouse truck with the lemons for in your kitchen. Or yeah, it doesn't matter where, you can use it anywhere in your home. And like I said, you can also leave this part away and just do some schoolboard paint on it, and you can write on it, and you can also remove it again. So that's also an option, just to use schoolboard paint. I love, and that for almost no cost. And my little gnome. And I'm so happy with my stripe fishtail. I'm happy I did it along the way. And you see the nice little gnome with his humblebees. And you just make something on your own, so it will be a unique piece. And the little farmhouse truck. And I think it turned out nice. But I will let you judge on it if you like it or not. And I hope you just make one of your own in what way or another. I just hope you like it and you just got a little bit of inspiration, like I always say. So this was my easy DIY. You just saw I didn't need almost nothing, a piece of cardboard, some painter's tear sticks, and of course some glue, some twine, and you're already in a print and you're already fit to go. I hope you just got a little bit of inspiration just to try something for your own. If you do and you would love to show it to us, just mail it to us. We would love to see it, and then we can show it on our community tab. So if you like, if you did make something of your own, just mail it to us. We would love to see it. So like I always said, if you like this content, if you like a little bit of chaos, I hope you will consider subscribing to the NMI channel. And we wish you all a beautiful, beautiful day. Stay safe, take care of yourself, and take care of each other. And we hope to see you in another video. Love from the NMI. Bye, everyone.